Welcome to Admissions and 15 Adventures.
Here at Pepperdine University, it's the fourth time around. The battle of the network stars, Net War 4.
Couldn't have said it better myself, Howard.
Breaking through the clouds, one sees the waves of Malibu Beach, California, and overlooking that scene set, the stars of ABC, NBC, and CBS have gathered there at Pepperdine University to do competitive battle. It's the fourth time around. ABC has won twice, NBC once, CBS without a victory. But a new leader, Captain Tony Randall, from The Odd Couple and The Tony Randall Show.
Howdy, folks.
It's all over, folks. It's all over.
Kevin Dobson of Kojak. It may be over for Kevin, but it's just beginning for James MacArthur of Hawaii 5-0. Grim, determined. And Denise Nicholas of Baby I'm Back.
Is my makeup good enough for you, Howard?
Perfect, Denise. And that's Mackenzie Phillips of One Day at a Time. That lovely is Victoria Principal of Dallas.
Oh, I've been practicing all night.
This is Big Bo Svensson of Big Bo, and how he's trained for this competition. And that's Jimmy Walker of Good Times.
Forget the rest, because CBS is the mess. Right here. Look out.
Leading the NBC team is Richard Benjamin of Quark. And he knows he's got a big girl on tap going for him. Here she is.
Played basketball all through college, captain of the team all the way. High school, too, had something like a, this is pretty good, Howard, 39-point average.
Go, go.
Rhonda Bates of Roller Girls. And Jane Curtin of Saturday Night Live.
Hi.
Dennis Dugan, Richie Brockelman, Private Eye. And a little girl comes in a chariot. Melissa Gilbert, A Little House on the Prairie.
I'm too little for all this.
And another little one, but old, Arte Johnson of Knockout.
No comment.
Where do I go?
I may do a little fandango myself.
A third small one, but tough. Lance Kerwin, James at 16.
Where's my horse at?
In.
I have a motorcycle down there. Where's the horse?
Larry Wilcox of Chips, and now, captain of the defending champions, Gabriel Kaplan. Welcome back, Potter. You listen to him long enough, you'll think he made a star of John Travolta. But he will be leading that lovely young lady, Debby Boone of Pat Boone and Family, with the year's biggest hit record, You Light Up My Life. And now the captain, Daryl Dragon, Captain and Tennille in Hawaii, with his lovely wife, Toni Tennille, from the same show, and she's an animated one. Kene Holliday, Carter Country.
Here we are at the Battle of the Network Stars, folks. And it's going to be a hot and heavy afternoon, we hope.
Yeah, a boy to run 103 seconds. Nice.
Steve Landesberg, Barney Miller.
I feel good about the whole race, you know. But four of our members have died, though.
Parker Stevenson, the Hardy Boys, the Ivy League hustler from Princeton. For a touch of rare international beauty, the queen of the high fashion models, embarking on a new career in television, with no apparent aptitude for football, Miss Cheryl Tiegs.
Thank you, Howard. You're so kind.
Kind indeed, Cheryl. And so, there she is, and there they are, 24 of the major stars of network television, about to begin another competition, the Battle
The Battle of the Network Stars is brought to you by Light Beer. Everything you've always wanted in a beer and less. And by Buick, currently celebrating its 75th anniversary. And by Buick dealers across the country. Buick, 75 years of cars that reflect the thinking of the times.
The battlefield is below. The captains are talking to their respective teams. A crowd of several thousand already on hand. For the first event, the swimming relay coming up.
Very interesting. What the least they could have done is given me a pair of water wings. These helmets are murder to swim in.
They're getting ready for the swimming competition. Look at the captain and Tennille. Victoria Principal. Alyssa Gilbert and Rhonda Bates.
I'm going to fall in and you run across my back and catch Rhonda. You're in there.
This breathtakingly beautiful young woman should be quickly recognizable to all of you. She was a participant in the Battle of the Network Stars, 1977 version. Since then, she has become the star of Three's Company and one of America's most familiar faces, Suzanne Summers, of course. This time, she will be the co-host of Net War 4, the Battle of the Network Stars, fourth time around. Welcome aboard.
Hello, Howard. How are you?
Snuggle some more.
Snuggle more? dirty old man, you.
That's true. Beauty and the Beast. Tell us, if you will,
yes,
what it was like to have been a participant in the competition last time.
Well, it's very scary because there's a lot of pressure. And the pressure comes from the incentive. And the incentive is that the total prize money is $360,000, which when you break it down means that each winner gets $20,000 for themselves, and that's quite a lot of loose change.
A lot of
Yes, and the second prize winner gets $15,000, and the loser, if you can call them losers, get $10,000. So it's terrific incentive. You get that last lap in there.
I remember the way you applied the last lap when you were in the swimming competition. You died in the water. In the meantime,
I told you I'm a one lap girl.
All right. My other colleague, as always, on this show, is that young man. Remember Montreal? The decathlon, the world's greatest athlete? Now, a Lothario, starring with Dorothy Hamill in her special.
Eat your heart out, Howard.
Let's get back to business here. There'll be seven events. Now, we're going to start off with swimming.
Rowing and a new event, the frisbee throw. Obstacle course, running relay, football, and then we're going to end it up with the tug of war. Now, the way the scoring is going to work, it's going to be 100 points for first place, 75 for second, 50 for third. There's one event that we're going to show today that won't be scored. It's a fun event. Lou Goldstein will be here to play Simon Says with all the stars. Suzanne, why don't you introduce the team?
Okay, Bruce. Boy, you cause an explosion wherever you go, don't you?
That's show business.
Okay, I think I see her finishing a glass of milk over there, leading off for ABC. The first leg is Debby Boone. She's going to light up everybody's life. She's really a cute girl. Following Debby in the second leg is Toni Tennille. There you go, Toni. Following Toni is her husband, the captain, Daryl Dragon. We'll see if he can keep his hat on. Ever seen the guy's hat? Kene Holliday is the fourth leg. He spelled his name a little strangely. It's K-E-N-E. And following Ken, our All-American boy, Parker Stevenson. He'll be swimming 50 meters. That's the ABC team. Now for CBS. Leading off with CBS is 6'6", Bo Svensson. He's been working out for this. Following Bo, who looks like a surprisingly strong swimmer, is Mackenzie Phillips. I think this next man needs a hand. He swam all the way from Hawaii, James MacArthur, our Harvard boy. And a rather attractive girl, Howard can attest to this, Victoria Principal. Swimming the anchor leg for CBS is Telly's sidekick, Kevin Dobson. That's the CBS lineup. Finally, the NBC lineup. Starting off in the first leg will be Larry Wilcox. He's quite an outdoorsman. He rides motorcycles and horses. Now we'll see how he does in the pool. The youngest competitor of all three is Melissa Gilbert. She's 13 years old, and I was talking to her earlier. She said she's quite nervous. 6 feet 2 inches tall, Rhonda Bates. Following Rhonda, we have Lance Kerwin. He's the boy who plays in James at 16, but he's really 17 years old. And finally, Dennis Dugan.
Good work, Suzanne. Quickly, the selection of the teams for this competition has been made entirely by the organizer of the event and not by the respective networks. Remember, too, five to a team, three men, two women. Each of the first four swimmers per team swims one width, 25 meters. The final swimmer, two widths, 50 meters. They're about ready. Great start by Big Bo Svensson for CBS. Immediately a huge lead. Larry Wilcox, NBC in the near lane. Debby Boone trailing in the far lane. And already Svensson reaches his mark, touches Mackenzie Phillips of CBS with almost a half-width lead. And Melissa Gilbert, you saw in the near lane, taking off Toni Tennille in the far lane. But Mackenzie Phillips right there is pouring it on. And the third one, James MacArthur of CBS, is already off. Coming up in the near lane, Melissa Gilbert. Rhonda Bates about to take off. And finally in the far lane, Daryl Dragon gets it from Toni Tennille. But look at this. CBS is already in its fourth lap with Victoria Principal. In the near lane is Rhonda Bates. And in the far lane is Daryl Dragon. And ABC is now second. Kene Holliday and Lance Kerwin take over for those two networks. But Victoria Principal is already touching. And Kevin Dobson is making a run of the swimming competition. Kevin Dobson, a great athlete. As you see, finally, Dennis Dugan get it for NBC and Parker Stevenson for ABC. But look at Dobson, beard and all. He's been waiting a long time to be a winner. CBS without ever having won in the previous three competitions. Kevin Dobson pouring it on. Parker Stevenson to the right now is leading Dennis Dugan. Parker Stevenson right there coming in second for ABC. Winding it up, trailing Dennis Dugan for NBC. Let's meet the winners.
This time they gave you a lead. There was
no... I know! A half a team! I can't believe it. We got it! We blew them out of the water!
Where is Jimmy?
This is all year. CBS is the best. At last, there's no stopping. There's no nothing. All the way.
What did you
do to the wall?
All the way. Did you bring in ringers? That's what
Victoria
I want to know.
Victoria Principal.
She was great. You really were. You did some job.
They've been coaching
me. Come on up here.
God, it feels good.
Get the winning team up here.
Hello. Jim MacArthur, another of the winners. Congratulations. Where is Bo? He gave you the big start. Hey, Bo, come here. You gave them the big start. You brought your team, really, what they had to have to achieve the victory. How much training have you guys been
doing? Oh, my God. Training? Oh. Yes.
We practiced a little. Dave, it seemed to be a little bit of a problem with the start of that race. Are you guys going to protest?
No, there was no problem with the start, but I have a serious protest. A gross infraction happened during that race. And I think everyone is quite aware of it. The captain lost his hat in the middle of the race.
That's right.
And yeah, I think that's definitely grounds for protest. That's definite
foul.
Did you have Popeye there without his spinach?
Of course I wouldn't, Dave. In fact, we have it well documented. As Daryl Dragon came off the starting blocks, he did right there lose his hat.
How about that, America? I think the captain's got to finish the race with his hat.
Gabe Kaplan without his chalkboard.
Right.
But I don't know if the protest is going to hold up, Gabriel. See, when Daryl Dragon came to the finish line, he was thinking ahead. He had a designated hat right there in the blue lane. You can see somebody handing him a hat at the finish line. That guy's always thinking ahead. Let's talk to him.
Tell him how the strength drained from your body is this fellow.
Yeah, I noticed that it came off, and I was surprised. It seemed like you slowed immediately right down in the water.
It's like Samson without his hair. Captain must have his hat.
And so, you look again at the huge lead given CBS by Bo Svenson of Big Mouth. After the first event, then, CBS the winner in a rout with 100 points. ABC with 75 points. NBC with 50 points.
Christian!
That's only the beginning.
That's right, I'm the captain, and ABC is going to win. Thank you very much.
ABC will rock you!
You can see that the atmosphere is festive as they prepare themselves for the rowing event.
But they're just trying out, Howard. We're not sure that these are the actual participants in the event. There's Daryl Dragon. He's very calm, nice even strokes, and Melissa.
Some of them, however, are just enjoying the show from ringside. Cheryl Tiegs, for instance. Her presence is felt wherever she is. And so is the presence of that young lady, Debby Boone. With the hit song of last year, who knows, maybe this year too, and for a lot of years. So beautifully rendered. She is, of course, one of four daughters of the famous Pat Boone. Carefully reared by Pat, in the father's image, but very much her own young lady, her career began really 8 years ago in Japan when she sang with the Osmonds. But as for her hit song, let her tell you what it means to her.
The song was given to me out of a movie, and it was a romantic love song. That was the intent of the lyric, but it really fit perfectly for me in a spiritual context, and that's the way that I did sing it. And as it has turned out, people have known that without even being told, and it's been a song of strength to people, and helped people overcome things, and it's been a wonderful thing, much more than just the success of a record.
Debby Boone could light up anybody's life. Well, we're almost set for the event. Each lap is from the starting position, up around the buoy, and back. I know Toni Tennille is leading off for ABC. Let's get her thoughts.
You let us down in the swimming, Toni.
Hey.
What's the matter?
I didn't let you down in the swimming. I swam as good as I could swim.
Have you ever handled a kayak before?
Yesterday, for the first time.
So you've had practice?
Yes.
You're confident?
I'm confident.
You feel that Kaplan provides adequate leadership?
Absolutely. He is dynamite. And I think our team is going to do it this time.
I hope so. Good
luck. I know it for sure.
Take care.
Okay.
I'll tell you one thing, Toni. For Gabe Kaplan, this event is a matter of family tradition.
The Kaplans are kayak people from a long time ago. From 1800 B.C., my great-great-uncle, Ace Ozark Kaplan, beat Attila the Hun in a kayak race. It was close. Attila ate the kayak after he lost. It was terrible.
All right. The teams are ready. We're going to start the rowing competition. Suzanne and Bruce will join in with me. The first lap will be rowed by Toni Tennille for ABC, Larry Wilcox for NBC, James MacArthur for CBS. CBS in the middle lane, ABC in the far lane, and in the near lane, Larry Wilcox for NBC. Look at the stroking. Toni Tennille, not quite direct, but still steady, short strokes, which are what you want. Right, Bruce?
Definitely, Howard. What you want to look for here is how Toni does with the rest of the going against two men, because she's the only woman on the team. And if she can stay with these men, it's going to be a tremendous advantage for ABC.
Big point, Bruce. Each team must have one woman, three men. Now, getting around that buoy is the toughest thing in the world, Suzanne. Look at the troubles they're having. Although MacArthur gets the lead for CBS, negotiating well. Wilcox still struggling. Toni Tennille is around it now. She's beginning to move ahead.
Once you try, you lose your control over your kayak once you're pushing too hard.
There you see it. CBS in the lead by about a length. Wilcox now in command of his boat. Toni Tennille hanging in there against the men. The point Bruce Jenner made, moving steadily. But James MacArthur will give the first lap lead to Kevin Dobson. Toni Tennille falling in the water, turning it over to Captain Gabriel Kaplan. Already pushing off is Kevin Dobson. And in the second spot for NBC is Janie Curtin, already in trouble, almost going out of her lane. Notice, that Gabriel Kaplan, with good, steady, short strokes, Bruce, has already caught up to Kevin Dobson.
Gabriel has an awful lot of experience in here, but so does Dobson. They're both very good, well-coordinated athletes. Their timing is good in the boat. It's going to be determined right here in the turn. Who can turn that boat the best?
I'll tell you, looking at Gabriel Kaplan, he looked like Attila the Hun, to whom he alluded earlier. But he's got the lead now. Dobson's having trouble, and Janie Curtin finally gets up to the buoy, trying to swing around.
Do you think she's sitting too far forward? Could that be the problem?
I don't know. I'll have to let Bruce attend.
She could be a little bit far forward, but the main thing is just trying to keep nice, even strokes and not try to overpower the boat. And that's what Dobson did right there.
Kevin Dobson, the great athlete, really fouled himself up. And look at the huge lead now that Gabriel Kaplan turns over to Ken Holliday of ABC. Kaplan jumping into the water and Kenny Holliday falling into the boat. ABC in commanding position. Dobson finally regains control of his boat. Now, CBS is in second position. And Denise Nicholas, she's lost the water. Did you see that?
She's pouring out the water. She doesn't want to get wet.
Always, all over Kevin.
Always feminine.
Okay. Now you see panoramically the lead that Gabriel Kaplan and ABC engendered, with Kenny Holliday now in trouble, having taken over from Kaplan.
Whoops. Plus,
Janie Curtin is finally in. She pushes off Lance Kerwin and that youngster. Look at that, Bruce.
That's good form right there. You can see how he's staying forward in the boat, keeping the boat level in the water, and trying to keep that boat moving as fast as he possibly can. Kenny having a lot of trouble right here getting around that buoy, but he's got such a big lead. But here comes Denise. See how she handles that turn.
And her hair's still dry.
Lance Kerwin is up to the buoy, too, but moving steadily ahead now with firm strokes is Ken Holliday. The ABC lead is reestablished.
Kenny's under control again. And you see how he's got a nice, smooth stroke. He's keeping that boat right down the middle. ABC looking very good right here. Coming into their last person, it's going to be Parker Stevenson anchoring for ABC.
Now, look what's happening here. Young Kerwin is overtaking Denise Nicholas. NBC will be in the second position. Holliday gives over to the anchor man, Parker Stevenson, the Ivy League hustler who was varsity crew at Princeton.
He knows what he's doing when he gets in that boat. Lance, a great job for the NBC team. He brings him in second place.
And Richard Benjamin from Quad, the captain of NBC, is their anchor man. CBS now last. All kinds of trouble.
Did you see Denise? After all that trouble, she's completely wet.
Stevenson, well in hand, confident, half smiling. And look what's happening to Bo Svensson, the anchor man for CBS. He almost fell right out of the boat. There's a guy who was too far back in the boat.
He definitely was. You can see, because he is so big and so heavy, he sits far back in the boat, it picked him right up.
Benjamin getting around the buoy.
There he is, having trouble.
Still having all kinds of trouble. But already coming in, the winner, ABC, with Parker Stevenson, just reason. Coming to hand, as they say in thoroughbred racing. So Parker Stevenson leads ABC as the anchorman to the victory, and the joy of ABC as they take the lead in the competition is apparent. And there is Richard Benjamin, NBC's captain, bringing NBC a needed second place. While much further down the track, big Bo Svensson. There was a point in time when I thought he'd displace all the water in the pool. There's Suzanne with the winners.
Strong people.
Out of a sick bed. This man came from
Texas. Out of a sick bed, you did it. And Todd, you're very strong. You're right in there with even strokes.
Thank you.
You had a little problem right in the middle there. With
lost it for a second, but then we got it back.
That's right.
All right, and the general glee on the part of the ABC team, suddenly there's a murky blur. Aww. Captain Tony Randall is filing a protest over the kayak competition for CBS. Tony?
I'm not saying we came in first, but there should be penalties against both ABC and NBC. Were the rules explained to the audience?
The rules were explained to the audience.
If you go over the... If you go over the dividing line, there are penalties. And I want to know if those penalties were assessed against the other teams. Because we did not cross the line at any time. But on our left, they did twice. And on the right, they did once.
All right.
Right. Tony Randall claims that NBC and ABC both went outside of their given lanes, in which case there would be an assessment of penalty points. That is his claim. However,
it's not a claim. Anybody could see it. I just want to make sure the penalty points.
Just a moment, Tony Mr. Randall. Your role as a judge on television belies the kind of vocal truculence just displayed. Mickey King is the commissioner of this competition, the great gold medalist for the United States in diving.
It's and the commissioner who decides.
Mickey will decide, exactly. We'll be back with a report from Mickey.
And I will be no less truculent, friends. You can count on that. Yes.
Very interesting. But if I had a U-boat, nobody would have won. Torpedoes loose!
I trust you remember Mickey King, Olympic gold medalist, now our commissioner. Mickey, as you know, Captain Tony Randall of CBS has asked that NBC and ABC be penalized, allegedly, for having kayaks go out of their respective lanes. Have you heard the protest and have you made a decision?
Yes, I have. I talked with Tony, and there's no doubt that there was some bumping into lanes and whatnot, but the rule clearly states that you have to go all the way into an opponent's lane, which did not occur. And so in my mind, there really is no justification for the protest, and the results stand as we saw in the finish.
Did Tony take it like the gentleman he is?
Terrifically. He was a fine gentleman, and he understood completely.
Thank you, Mickey. So the CBS protest is denied, officially.
Thank you for clearing that up, Howard. So CBS in the rowing winds up third, NBC second, and ABC on top. And as our little buddy brings in the overall score, after two events, you see ABC on top, CBS, and then NBC. A new event to the competition this year was frisbee catch, and we brought in an expert to show everybody how it's done. Ashley Whippet, world champion frisbee catching dog, and he can get off the ground.
Look at that form. He had a terrific partner, though.
I did. Bo Svensson was so impressed with Ashley that he had to try it himself.
Yes, this guy gives 100%. I'd like to be his dentist. Ooh, ow.
The rules were simple. There were four people on the team. If you caught the frisbee, you got 2 points. If you missed it, the other team got 2 points. If a team served out of bounds, the receiving team got a point, and there were 32 points in a game. Down on the field, Suzanne and I tried out our skills at catching and throwing that frisbee earlier, and Suzanne, it isn't that easy, is it?
Oh, come on, Bruce. It's a snap. All it takes is concentration and keeping your eye on the frisbee.
Old Butterfinger.
Well, I was just testing that time. Let's try it one more time and see how I do. See? Nothing to it.
Ah, it looks so graceful.
Yeah. That away, girl. Yep. Give it to him.
Little hot dog in there. The competition went this way. There were two preliminary games. The first game was ABC versus CBS, and CBS came away with the victory. The second game, it was ABC and NBC, and ABC won that one. So the final match, ABC went against CBS. CBS came away with the victory with a score of 32 to ABC's 26.
And again, Bo Svensson is the key figure for the CBS victory. I'm really impressed with him. How about you, Howard?
Suzanne, I think your observations are absolutely well taken. There is an almost indomitable cut about that man. The huge size that's so dominant. And then the background. A captain in the United States Marine Corps, though Swedish-born, and in that capacity once broke both his legs. Used to race stock cars, and then, as if to manifest his versatility, picked up a third-degree black belt in karate. Can do anything. And what might have been in terms of athletics for him, listen.
I never became a very fine hockey player, and that's always irritated me, and I don't know if I even had the talent, you know, to play in the NHL, but physically I'm hampered by my knees. I can't move as well laterally, etc., as I ought to be able to. I've learned by having been knocked around a bit that there's so much to enjoy in life, and from... those sentiments, I would say, yes, I am a winner because I'm a happy human being. I don't want to be 60 or 65 and look back at my life and be able to say, Why didn't I try that? Why didn't I drive race cars? Or why didn't I play hockey? I've always loved doing that. I don't want to look back at my life with any kind of regret. I want to make films. I want to make good films. You know? So, yeah. Maybe I am looking to tomorrow, after all. You know, maybe I am waiting for that script to come in and I can say, gee, this is great. This is wonderful. Look at that. Look at this guy here. So, who knows? I mean, today is wonderful. I hope tomorrow will be equally wonderful.
Bo Svenson is an immensely likable guy, isn't he? Meantime, the atmosphere grows again gay. The cheerleaders at work, Victoria, Prince of Printing around. Why? Because coming up, the most difficult test of all in the battle of the network stars, the obstacle course. Toni Tennille trying to prepare for it. That comes up next. They're getting ready for the most challenging event of all, the obstacle course competition. Quickly, let me tell you what takes place. There are six preliminary heats, three for men and three for women, and then there are two final heats. During the preliminary heats, the lowest cumulative times, man and woman, the two lowest get into the final heats. And then the lowest cumulative time in the final heats, men and women, for any given team, emerges as the winning team. Now, Bruce Jenner, detail the course for us.
Okay, Howard, quickly. You first go underneath the ropes right there. You come up through the tires, through the monkey bars are next. Now, this you have to watch out. You have to be under control as you go through that. Over the wall, through the water jump, and then the last final sprint to the finish line.
In all fairness, take that.
All right, we'll do just that, Tony. Good sport. And, of course, as they get ready for the competition, Cheryl Tiegs will be leading off for ABC, and her opponent will be Victoria Principal. We're not disposed to let the two contestants get off without appropriate words. Suzanne.
Cheryl. Yes. I give you full marks because I wouldn't do this last year. I was a little nervous. How do you feel about it?
Well, you keep saying that and how dangerous it is, and I think it's going to be fun. I'm not scared at all. Maybe after I'm finished, I will not do it next year.
What about the tire, the obstacle of running through the tires? Have you tried that?
I've tried it, and it's fairly easy. I think I've done it all, and the thing is to do it fast, and that's when you make mistakes and trip on the tires.
Well, you're not only terrific to look at, you're a terrific sport, so thanks a lot. And good luck, okay?
It's so bad, is it?
Victoria, you got your work cut out for you. Going against Cheryl Tiegs right off the bat. How's your practice been going?
Fine. I came out this morning, warmed up a bit, went through it once, and went and had coffee.
And you're ready.
Yeah.
I saw you here also stretching out and just loosening up an awful lot. I was sort of surprised. It seems like you're really getting into this.
Oh, yes. Well, I think one of the main things is to come and enjoy yourself and do well, but not to get hurt.
Is this a key event for you?
I would say so. Unfortunately, we've got one person hurt and one person sick, so I'm kind of, yeah.
Well, good luck to you.
All right, thank you. Okay,
thank you.
The one person hurt, Bo Svenson, damaged shoulder during the Frisbee competition. The sick one, Mackenzie Phillips. We're about ready for the start.
Runners ready.
And they're off. Quickly, they've got to get under that. And the taller Cheryl does it very well, but Victoria Principal gets an early lead. Both navigate the tires effectively. Now to the handboards, and they're almost even. Still, Victoria Principal with a slight lead. The wall should provide a major challenge for her, but it doesn't. Now she's in the lead as they approach the water obstacle and then the stretch. Nothing between them now. In fact, down the stretch, it's Cheryl Tiegs for a close victory over Victoria Principal. So Cheryl Tiegs' words stood up that she uttered to Suzanne before the race. Let's talk with her.
True, I didn't believe you could get through the course.
I'm athletic. You didn't believe it.
No, it's like Suzanne told you. She didn't have the guts to do it last year. You at least tried it. You not only tried it, but you've apparently won.
Absolutely. It wasn't as hard as I thought. She kept telling me how dangerous it was. Thank you.
Well, that's a gentleman. That's a gentleman leader from CBS.
Thank you.
Victoria, congratulations for getting through the course.
Looks like Cheryl Teague's confidence that she showed us before the race has sort of pulled her through, Suzanne.
Well, something I didn't realize, it takes a lot of grace and coordination to complete this event. And they're both very graceful, coordinated girls. Now, Cheryl has a little bit of an advantage because she has those long, long legs.
Yes, I noticed that.
I'm sure you did, Bruce. But they're neck and neck right here.
You can see where Cheryl's legs do pull her through right here at the end. As she comes over the water jump, it's a sprint to the finish line, and it's a dead heat right there, but Cheryl pulls away right at the last little bit. Howard?
And it's the beginning only of the obstacle course. Coming up, Debby Boone against Rhonda Bates. Heat of the obstacle course featuring the elongated one, Rhonda Bates, and her opponent, relatively diminutive as you look at Rhonda and precious Debby Boone. Here's Bruce.
Rhonda, it looks like you have one bad wheel there.
Yep, one bad wheel and one real big wheel.
Well, does that even out?
I don't know. I will have to see, Bruce.
You know, being bigger, it must be a little harder trying to get underneath the rope there.
You know, everything about this thing's hard.
There's nothing easy.
That's right, and being bigger is even harder. Gotta hang, a lot more bods gotta hang on those monkey bars.
Well, you can put your feet on the ground. Good luck to you.
Thanks a lot, Bruce.
Okay.
Take care.
Rhonda Bates, so tall, so funny, so willing to talk openly about herself. I asked her, for instance, how she got her first break in show business.
My first break was with Don Rickles on the CBS special that he had. But they called and they said, Rhonda, the show ran 18 minutes over, and we got to cut you or Frank Sinatra. I said, how'd Frank take the news?
Never developed a complex, though, as a girl, over being so tall.
Well, it was some problems, you know, being so tall, like finding somebody to marry, like Donald. He was taller, so I married him. He came through town, we got married. But, it's an adjustment, but you got to live with it. You can't get shorter.
Well, Rhonda, you play Mungo Sue Lambert in Roller Girls. Did you have to do a lot of training to play the part, physical training?
We had to start 2 months ahead of shooting and work out 3.5 hours a day with the L.A. Thunderbirds. They taught us how to do a lot of the stuff and get in shape and be able to skate 10 minutes without stopping, things like that, build up endurance. They were really great coaches.
Did you get banged up at all?
I had so many bruises, Howard, you could have connected the dots and made little pictures all over my body.
What an utterly self-possessed girl, and bright with a master's degree in communications. But now, the pace quickens, ready for the start of the heat. Let's see how Rhonda Bates can navigate. They're off, and immediately, as Bruce Jenner predicted, trouble with those ropes. Debby Boone, meanwhile, building up a big lead. Trouble, too, with the tires for Rhonda. But at the handbars, Debby had a little bit of trouble. The lead appeared to be cut down, but it was even worse for Rhonda. Now let's see how she negotiates that wall. Oh, good Lord. Oh, terrible. Just a debacle for Rhonda Bates. Debby Boone coming on in with an easy victory. The water obstacle couldn't be breasted. Cry havoc for Rhonda Bates. Debby Boone, the winner.
Debby, congratulate. Up, she's gone. Hold on, let's get a good shot of her. She's gone. Let me talk to Rhonda first. This has to be the most extraordinary performance in the history of the event.
Hey!
What happened going under those bars, that long, loose angle of body? What went wrong?
Howard, you know what? Too much was hanging.
I think we better leave that one right where it is.
Yeah.
And the youngster was just too good.
Debbie's pretty good. How old are you, girl? 14.
14. I'm 86.
There were three key points of the race for Rhonda and Suzanne. There was one of them right there.
Yes, those legs got in the way right there.
The other point that she had as she came up is she used her height to an advantage. She only touched the first, the middle, and the last bar on the monkey bars. That helped her out there.
Whoops.
But Rhonda couldn't get through that water jump, couldn't get those legs out of the water.
You know what, Bruce?
What?
There was too much hanging.
And to add insult to injury, I almost strangled her with my microphone cord. But back to the action. We're ready for a men's heat. Kevin Dobson of CBS against Larry Wilcox of NBC. Both fine athletes. Dobson, a veteran of every prior competition. Here's Bruce with Kevin.
How you going against Larry Wilcox? He should be tough.
He is tough. Animal.
On your marks and go get him.
Okay, thank you.
Remember, Kevin, in the swimming competition, swimming the anchor laps and bringing CBS a victory. I asked him if his wife has influenced his career.
She talked me into the whole operation. I was punching tickets on the Long Island Railroad in New York. And she thought I could get into commercials and get into modeling. And that's how it started. That was 12 years ago. And I've been doing Kojak for the last 4 years, five seasons.
Early on, though, it was terribly discouraging, wasn't it, as you were trying to get ahead?
Well, after I did the first show in the start of my career in 1966, I didn't work very much after that. I spent 5 years in New York banging on doors, doing whatever, tending bar, waiting tables, driving cabs. Finally left New York, came out to L.A., came out to Hollywood to make it on Broadway. My first job in L.A. was washing dishes in a restaurant out here. Ended up working for another railroad, the Santa Fe Railroad, where I was jockeying engines all over L.A. When I quit that after almost 2 years, I was making passenger runs, round-trip passenger runs from L.A. to San Diego and back. I quit that to do another play called Streetcar Named Desire, where I was understudying the lead, John Voight, and I thought that was going to be my opportunity. Unfortunately, it wasn't, but 6 months after that came Kojak, and I just felt so right about it, and I just went at it and got it.
That's the kind of man Kevin Dobson is. Dobson and Wilcox about to take off. There they go. Quickly under the ropes, both with apparently equal facility. The tires easily negotiated by both, but Wilcox with the early lead. The monkey bars. And Wilcox building perhaps an even better lead. Now the wall. And Wilcox beautifully off it, but that's where Dobson lost ground. But Dobson is trying to make it up. An extraordinary finish. Absolutely extraordinary.
I have no idea. That had to be a photo finish. What a spectacular finish, Larry. You did a great job. Congratulations. But Dobson, who appeared out of it right after his fall over the wall, came on tremendously. You made a mistake, my friend. You looked over at him, and you know
that's
that.
That's right. I know. Once you look over, there's another half a second. He's a heck of an athlete.
He really is. And you flung your body across that finish line. I wish I knew which of you really to congratulate as the winner. A photo finish.
Why not call it that and leave it at that? That was a great race.
Coming off the wall, Kevin Dobson has trouble trying to get out of the pit.
But the key is the water jump. Look at Kevin Dobson grabs with one hand and really leaps over rather than pulls himself across.
But Larry Wilcox is given the win because his torso is ahead of Kevin right there. Alan?
All right, Bruce. I want you and Suzanne to take a look. There's Wilcox looking back, as I indicated in the interview with him. That's what made the finish so terribly close. You gotta give Dobson all the credit in the world. The head bouncing as he looked around, and that cost him at least a half a second, as Larry said. What a race. Larry Wilcox is an engaging cowboy raised in Wyoming, loving the outdoors. Developed his love for motorbikes there, but above all, horses and rodeo. Listen to him talk about it.
When I was in high school, I did a little rodeoing. I did bareback and bulls, and I can't do it now. I'm doing television series because of injuries and so on. But I do roping, and I've only been team roping for about a year and a half. And I've messed around with ropes, but not really to extent of going to rodeos. Last year, we went to a rodeo in Santa Barbara, and out of 95 ropers, we placed seventh. So all I can say is I'm coming on, and I just hope I keep getting better. I better tell Jimmy Conn to look out. I've never felt that I want to be, I hate the term, quote, movie star, but I like to think that I'll be respected by my peers, and by peers, I mean other actors. I want to have a feeling that they recognize the talent and feel that when they see work that there is some kind of art involved. If I can accomplish that as an actor, I'll feel like I've done, you know, just what I need to do in this profession.
I'm going where the sun keeps shining.
Suits my clothes.
crazy. If you go through that so easy, those other guys got bad hips and big boots. I can't do that. You're crazy.
The six preliminary heats over. NBC and CBS in the finals. Here, NBC is encouraging Melissa Gilbert, who will represent them, she having had the fastest female preliminary time.
Yeah, but much closer.
We're ready for the finals in the women's obstacle competition. And it'll be Victoria Principal for CBS against Melissa Gilbert of NBC. Here's Bruce with Melissa.
Hey. Melissa, you're into the finals. You're getting closer and closer.
Yeah, I'm nervous, too.
Why should you be nervous?
I don't know. Well, I guess I'm not nervous anymore.
Well, we solved that problem. Now all we do is get through this course.
Yeah, well, we need this point, the score, because NBC is way behind, and this is one way we can catch up. We'll still be in third place if we win this, but it'll give us a less... We won't have to work so hard to get second place.
Okay, good luck to you.
Thanks.
All right, we're ready for the start of the event. Melissa going to her spot, the opponent Victoria Principal. In a sense, youth against experience. Call it that if you want. You can't call Victoria Principal aged. That's for sure. Melissa, with apparently growing confidence. Victoria, tense, awaiting the starter's gun. There they go. Quickly under the ropes. Easy for Melissa and easy for Victoria, too. Melissa with a little bit of a lead. Trouble with the tire there for Melissa, but she apparently went back and made up for it. Quickly to monkey bars. Melissa now developing a lead. Victoria trailing to the wall. Right here, the key always in the girls' events. Melissa off it beautifully. Victoria in trouble, way behind. Melissa breezing to the victory. And so, thank heaven, the little girls. Melissa!
Congratulations again, dear. Barring penalty, you won with ease. And you've got your team ahead now in the finals.
I hope so.
Done in, huh, baby?
Yes.
Okay, go take a rest. Get congratulated by your...
Thank heaven. Four little girls. Four little girls get bigger every day. Thank heaven. Four little girls, they grow up in the most delightful way. Those little eyes so helpless and appealing, one day will flash and send you crashing through the ceiling. Thank heaven. Four little girls. Thank heaven for them all, no matter where, no matter who. Without them, what would little boys do? Thank heaven. Thank heaven.
Melissa Gilbert. And with me, Suzanne Summers and Bruce Jenner, as we continue in the battle of the network stars with the men's finals in the obstacle course competition, and that's young Lance Kerwin. James at 16, if you will. Kevin Dobson, Kelly's aide, as Suzanne called him earlier, is the opponent. Victoria Principal, having lost in the finals, has lost none of her collegiate verve. She leads the cheering.
This is my best event, Howard.
Why? All right. We're ready for the start. There they go, under the ropes. And quickly, Kevin Dobson assumes a slight lead to get to the monkey bars. And Kevin Dobson still with a little bit of an edge. Now, the wall. Beautiful by Kerwin. Terrible by Dobson. Lance wins easily. So he and Melissa Gilbert have proved that youth can triumph.
NBC back into the thick of the competition. No. You beat one fine athlete, Kevin Dobson. You had a toughie to beat. Kevin, I'm sorry, but you had a fall prey to you.
The best always shows. There you go, Lance. Good run.
There you go. Lance, great job. Nothing more need be said. You brought your team back into the competition. Good luck
to you.
Richard, congratulations.
Thank you. We just need more kids. We need more children on our team.
That'll be...
Kevin and Lance seem to have no problem when it comes to negotiating the monkey bars, but Suzanne, it seems like Kevin had problems when it came to the wall.
Yeah, Kevin gets a little hung up in the ropes here. You can see he slips, whereas Lance is just flipping right over, and then he has the added advantage of landing on his feet, which gives him a running start. You see, Kevin lands on his posterior.
Well, Lance Kerwin did the job, and he's a fascinating kid. James at 16, really 17. He understands his role and discusses his show.
Basically, people ask me about my character. They're used to seeing, I think, 21-year-old, 15-year-olds, like the Sweat Hogs or in Welcome Back, Cotter, or Happy Days. And I say to myself, well, sure, there's those kind of people like Fonzie and the Sweat Hogs, but there's more kids, just like the average kid in high school, maybe a little short for his age, not altogether so swift, a little clumsy, trying to get girlfriends. And so we're showing the things that go on in growing up. They say our show might be risque, is where we deal with sex and everything. But I don't think we do. I think we're just dealing with things that everyone goes through in life and growing up.
Oh, James, I never feel this way before. You're so special to me.
And you to me.
Youth does have its problems, but NBC, by winning the obstacle event, has now made a three-way race of it. There are the scores. We are at the campus of Pepperdine University, high above Malibu Beach, and coming up next, the running relay. Getting ready, Rhonda Bates and Jane Curtin. Jimmy Walker, getting ready to work on the cinder blocks, get off to the good start. And Kevin Dobson, getting a needed rub down after what he's been through from Captain Tony Randall of CBS. In the meantime, too, the college atmosphere continues apace. And you know something? Arte Johnson's on the NBC team. He's a rabid sports fan. And he is often giving to near philosophic comments about some of his favorite sports.
Oh, by some wonderful coincidence, today happens to be the 3,276th anniversary of the discovery of jogging. A wonderful occasion when you think of it. It started back in the old days when the Israelites were denied the use of straw in the making of bricks by the Pharaoh. And as a result, they had to jump excessively hard to compact the clay to build bricks. And as we all know, the pyramids are still standing today because of the efforts of those wonderful people who make bricks without straw. Moses.
Arte Johnson dreams. Let's get on with the event. And of course, there are six people, each team, two women, four men. Another thing, three passing zones are on the track. Batons must be passed within those zones. More details, Bruce and Suzanne.
All right, well, let me try to explain what's going to happen now. Now, in the relay race, we're going to have 110 yards, another 110 yards. The next runner has to run 220 yards. Okay, you got that. Now, that's three runners. The other three runners have to run 110 again, 110, and then 220 yards. So you have six runners, a total of 880 yards twice around. You got that. Well, if you think that sounds complicated, you ought to try saying it.
I'm glad he did. Oh, come on, Howard, you know I'm only teasing, don't you?
I knew it. I know you know the rules. And there is Cheryl Tiegs, ABC, in the middle lane. To the left, Jimmy Walker of CBS. And bringing up the rear, Arte Johnson up from his reverie. About ready now for the start. Beautiful start for Jimmy Walker. And quickly, he springs way out in front. Little Arte Johnson, dreaming no longer, catching up to Cheryl Tiegs. Her task to hold her own with Johnson, because way out front is Jimmy Walker, ready to pass the baton to Denise Nicholas. And so he does. Denise Nicholas with a big lead. Melissa Gilbert, number two for NBC. But Captain Gabe Kaplan almost immediately overtakes her and is closing in on Denise Nicholas. So his early strategy seems to have worked. Now James MacArthur gets it from Denise.
and Parker Stevenson from Captain Kaplan. And running third is Lance Kerwin for NBC. And look at them now. Closing in on MacArthur is Parker Stevenson. He's passing MacArthur. Right there. Look at that. Turned his ankle, but still holds together, Bruce. A real achievement for Parker Stevenson as he passes off to little Debby Boone. ABC in the lead, but Debby Boone has to go against Bo Svensson. And to Debby, Bo must look like Ichabod Crane as Bo moves out to a lead. Forget about NBC. It's Gene Curtin running, and they are dead. Bo Svensson handing off to Victoria Principal. But she's got to worry about Steve Landesberg of ABC. Larry Wilcox of NBC is way out of your picture. Look at Landesberg. He's passing Victoria Principal. Final lap. And Kene Holliday gets it from Landesberg. Kevin Dobson from Victoria Principal. It's a showdown between those two. And Dobson has too much space to overtake. Just too much. Dobson, a fine runner. But Holliday, a man with a football scholarship to the University of Maryland. And Kenny holding together. Because Dobson has gained back some ground, but Holliday knows he has the race in hand. So ABC wins the race, and Dennis Dugan, bringing up the rear, does it quite appropriately, moving in backwards. ABC wins the competition. Let's talk to the winners. Well, congratulations. First of all, great performance by the...
Thank you, Howard.
Going against Kevin.
See?
Dobson's not
no easy. Tires. I breezed through.
I'll tell you what won this race. I'm serious now for you, Pete. Your captain strategy.
That's right. Absolutely.
Captain Kaplan. Now, explain to the camera right here, Gabe, what the strategy was, why you placed Cheryl where she was and Debby where she was.
Well, I thought if we went into Parker just a little behind... Parker would get the lead, Debby would lose a little bit, fourth, and I knew Steve and Ken were the fastest fifth and sixth man, so I didn't want to get too far behind by putting the two women first.
They did and, the same thing
and
a
Cheryl,
year ago.
And Cheryl almost kept even.
If I could just keep it even, then we had a chance. Absolutely.
With Arte Johnson, she kept even with Arte Johnson, and Jimmy got a good start, but... Parker was winning when we came
back. Y'all did very well. He was terrific. Debby, you looked like you were chasing Ichabod Crane, I must say. But you were just great. Good luck to all of you.
Thank you.
Good job, Captain Kaplan. Good job.
Thank you very much. I wish I could say the same about your sports team.
You know, Howard, when Parker Stevenson came off that turn, he sprained his ankle. Dr. Leroy Perry is looking at it, and... Suzanne, it looks like Parker's in some pain.
Yeah, but it looks like he had sprained it previously because it's already taped up. So he ran this race knowing he had the sprained ankle. And here's the replay where we'll see him. It comes right here. Yes, you can see where he just sprained his ankle and he ran on in spite of it. That's really amazing.
Well, he is an amazing fellow, Suzanne. And, of course, that kind of guts is a hangover from his competitive days at Princeton, old Nassau. So, we have a tie. ABC and CBS at 400 points. NBC in the rear. And what is this? Tony Randall and Melissa Gilbert getting instructions. And Simon Says from Lou Goldstein of Grossinger's. And we'll be back with that little respite from the competition in just a moment.
Yeah,
okay.
Says, do you want a chance?
Yes!
Simon says, go back. Hold it! You're out again! That's it! Simon says, Tony, over here. Hold it! Simon says, you're out, Tony. Simon says, forward stretch one. Simon says, hands down. Smile, Richard. You're out! That's it! Bye-bye! Simon says,
everybody
over
says
here, Lance.
Smile.
What's your last name? You're out. Have a nice trip. What? Kerwin, you want a chance? Simon says, ask him. Say, Lou, give me a chance. Simon says, say it loud.
Lou, give me a chance.
Come on back. Simon says, come on back. Hold it. Oh, you're terrific. Say, you're out. That's it. That's it. That's it. Simon says, that's it. Simon says, over here, young man. Kevin, you want to be in? Simon says, you want to be in?
Yes.
Get in front of Jim. Simon says. Today, Simon says, get in front of Jimmy. Hold it. God, Simon says, hold it. Take a step back. Simon says, take a step back. Jim, put your hands down. Simon says, are you up or down? It's hard to tell. Simon says, hands down. Simon says, Jim, and you can, young man, you're leaving in a second. Hawaiian 5-0, you're a nervous wreck. Put your hands down. Simon says, put your hands up. That's up. So long. Simon says, Jimmy, over here. Simon says, over here, Captain. Simon says, no, no, right there. Simon says, right there. Right over here. What is your real name? Simon says, hold it. Simon says, what is your real name? Say it loud. You're terrific. Hands down. Simon says, put your hands up. That's up. So long, Dragon. Simon says, over here. You can put your hands up. Simon says, put your hands up. That's up. So long, Stevie. Bye-bye. Artie. Simon says, Artie. Watch my lips. Simon says, Artie, get... Look at me. Simon says, look down. Okay, you're not... Simon says, you stay there. Simon says, over here, Artie. Hurry up. Don't rush. Simon says, throw the flower down. Simon says, look at me, Art. Simon says, look at Debbie. Simon says, what do you think of Debbie? Simon says, what is your famous phrase for Debbie? Simon says, say it.
Very interesting.
Simon says, hands up. Bo, over here. Simon says, wave your hands. Simon says, hold it. So long, Kevin. Bye-bye. Simon says, over here, Cheryl. You can put your hands down, Jim. Simon says, put your hands up. Simon says, hands down. Jimmy, over to your left. Bye-bye, Jimmy. Simon says, over to your left. Over to your left. I don't have time. Simon says, over to your left. Simon says, Debbie, over here. Rhonda, right over there. Simon says, over to your left. What is your last name?
Bates.
You're out. Simon says, over to the left. Simon says, over here. Something will hold you up. Simon says, over to your left. Simon says, stay away from her. Simon says, you, Bo. Simon says, take a deep breath in. Out. Well, we'll see how long you hold it. Simon says, out. Simon says, Debbie, sing.
Oh, no.
Simon says, sing. Simon says, don't laugh. Simon says, sing.
You give me love. You give me love.
Hold it.
You lie.
Well, we'll get music with the game. Simon says, hold it. Simon says, take
Simon,
a step back.
Simon?
Are you still breathing?
Can I go to the bathroom?
No, Simon says, hold it. Simon says, step back. Simon says, take a step back. Simon says, now. Simon says, face Cheryl. Go over here. Simon says, go take a step back. That's back. Have a nice stretch. Simon says, over here. Simon says, over to the left. Simon says, Cheryl, face Artie. Oh, he's coming to life. Simon says, walk towards him. Simon says, the game is now on. Simon says, everything must be done. Simon says, stand up straight. Well, you are straight. Simon says, feet together. Simon says, Artie, think of the pleasure you could have if I say Simon says. Simon says, Cheryl, place your hands forward, past the shoulders. Simon, not on his shoulders. Simon says, past the shoulders. Simon says, you place your arms under hers. Simon says, Simon, give her a hug for a lousy game. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Simon says, embrace her. Simon says, separate. Simon says, there's nobody left. Simon says, Debbie, come with me.
So Luke Goldstein leaves with Debby Boone. But you just saw something very special. One of the world's most beautiful and now recognized women, Cheryl Tiegs, having fun, participating. A whole new career before her, but already tops in the world as a high fashion model. The cover of Time. Look anywhere at any magazine, and the thing about Cheryl is that she's not just a picture, she's a personality. And how did it all begin? Let Cheryl herself tell you.
When I was in high school, somebody came up and said that I should be a model. I was at a club dinner, and there was a speaker there, an agent. And after the talk, he came and said that I should come to see him, and I did, and that's how I really started. Glamour magazine booked me to St. Thomas for a trip, and that was during high school, and I got a cover from that and a whole issue. And at the end of 2 years of college, I decided to go to New York for the summer to see what it was like.
Cheryl was on an assignment with a friend of mine who was living with me for a short while, who was a photographer, a fashion photographer. Invited her up for a drink. She said sure, it was after the shoot, and she came up, and I walked out of my bedroom, and there she was sitting on the couch, and whammo, just like that.
Whammo, just like that. Cheryl has been on over 100 magazine covers, American and European. When she met her husband, Stan Dragotti, a producer, director, and writer, she was in love. They were married in 1970, moved back to California that year. You know what she did? She stopped modeling. She wanted a marriage that would work. So for 2 years, she did nothing. And then she came back to the business on her own terms. And then a controversial picture in Sports Illustrated.
When I was modeling that bathing suit, you have to leave it up to the discretion of Sports Illustrated as to whether they want to use it or not. The bathing suit got wet. I didn't know you could see through it, but you could. The lighting, all that has a big factor in it. And I think that the only way to not have a picture like that published is to never have a picture taken, because you take thousands of pictures, and of course there's going to be one that's, you know, that maybe you wouldn't want published. I think in modeling, I've gone to the top, and I've done as well as I could do in modeling, so that's very satisfying. It's very nice. And now I'll go into another career, go to the top of that. Once you're on top of one thing, I think you should definitely move on to something else.
And she's got a whole new career ahead of her. Television. Al Jolson put it best.
I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You made me want to. And all the time you knew it. I guess you always knew it. You made me happy sometimes. You made me glad. But there was time, baby. You made me feel so bad. You made me cry, Pa. I didn't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you. I want some love. That's true. Yes, I do. Indeed, I do. You know I do. Gimme, 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 gimme what I cry for. You know you got the kind of kisses that I die for. You know you made me love you.
From the sublime to the ridiculous, Cheryl Tiegs will play football. As As the competition progressed, conditions became more and more grueling. Obviously, rehabilitation measures were in order. Bruce Jenner, suppose you explain.
Well, we have to remember these are not professional athletes. They haven't spent that much time on the athletic field training for this. And we have Dr. Perry here and Gary Tuthill of the Rams trying to help them with their aches and pains. But as you can see, it's taking its toll.
Taking its toll primarily, Bruce, upon the knees. As Vince Lombardi always used to say, the knee. It's always the knee. But in the long run, the doctor's efforts seem to be worth it, as you can now see.
Never take your eye off the ball. And when you go to catch it...
That is, as I said, good quarterbacking, Bruce.
It's certainly a smart play, and when you go for the short, just down and across and catch it between the five-yard line and that goal line, and you get it 2 points. Now here we can see it again. Tony Randall coming across the middle.
And once again, the ineptitude of Steve Landesberg as the would-be defender.
Right there in your hands.
All right, back in the huddle. Kevin Dobson now with Denise Nicholas and Victoria Prince.
To Toni Tennille. She's going to back up. When you see her start to back up, just stop and turn around. But you're only going to run 4 steps anyway. Don't indicate to her that you're going to stop and turn around. Okay?
Dobson knows what he's doing, Bruce. I like the way he's using those receivers and anticipating the moves or non-moves of the defenders.
He's doing a good job right here. We'll have to see what comes out. He's going to have Denise go right down about 4 steps and come right back in. It's a short pass. Oh, right there. But Toni Tennille, good defensive play. Had her hands right in there.
Score remains CBS 7. ABC is yet to get the football, of course, and Toni Tennille did a good job of defending.
Okay. Just run across the field. Right?
Straight
line. Yeah, because I'm going to fake a pass to her. I'm going to hit you in the end zone.
Okay.
Yeah, but catch your name.
Okay. Dobson's going to fake a pass to Denise Nicholas and try to hit Victoria Prince.
Victoria's going to go right across the middle on this one. You see her. Oh, she's open. Oh, the pass just barely overthrown a little bit. Would have been a tough catch, but she wasn't able to pull it in.
You must catch it gently like an egg, in Dobson's words.
Yes.
You throw the ball as soon as he starts to rush.
Yes.
Throw the ball.
All right.
Jimmy, you give us 2 points.
Okay.
Get us 2 points. If you see you can't throw it, hit Jimmy. Because Jimmy's going to run like this. Look. He's just going to run up to that 5-yard mark and then come across the center.
Okay.
All right, Bruce, we've got a new twist here. Dobson in the role of deep receiver. Jimmy Walker, short receiver. James MacArthur is quarterback with an option. To hit either Walker or Dobson, why don't you take over and report the action?
James MacArthur, going to be quarterbacking now. You got your receivers. Walker. And he goes for Dobson. He's going for the tackle. Great catch by Kevin Dobson. Jumps up in the air and hits a touchdown. The official puts his arms up in the air. 5 points for the CBS team.
Dobson doing a terrific job in leading the CBS team as we look at it in replay. Now you see Dobson, a down and out, and quickly the grab. Kene Holliday all over him, but Dobson just too big, too sure-handed. There's his wife, Susie. I don't blame you, Susie. He's doing some job.
Jim will just run straight up his mark and turn around. That's what you do.
Okay.
Right over there.
Okay.
All right. This time, probably, MacArthur will go for the two-pointer. CBS in the lead, 12-0. Over ABC. ABC yet to get the football. Each side, by the way, gets 6 plays. No, it's Walker back in the quarterback role. And he hits MacArthur, just short of the touchdown, but a two-pointer. I like the way Dobson has led his team strategically. That's 14-0. CBS in the lead over ABC. And it's worth it to catch a football for that, Bruce.
On that team, it certainly is. It wasn't like that when I played football.
When you played football, nothing was like that. Once again, Cheryl Tiegs, as we get ready, looking down panoramically at the field for the second play. Let's watch Kaplan. Again, he throws deep, this time intended for Debby Boone. Victoria Principal all over Debby, joint possession. The rule is that the offensive receiver gets credit for the catch. And so quickly, touchdown, 14-10, CBS over ABC. Kene Holliday's exuberance, Bruce, was visible.
It's an exciting moment. Debby Boone is able to pull that ball right in and score 5 points. The ABC women are coming through. Gabriel Kaplan throws long. The bottom left of your screen, you see Debby Boone and Victoria Principal. The ball is a little bit underthrown. You see Debby Boone moving back into the ball. Victoria and Debby both have possession of the ball. As Howard stated, the offensive player gets the reception. Touchdown, ABC.
And so with the score, CBS 14, ABC 10, let's see where Kaplan takes them. We're back with the football competition. While away, three times, Captain Kaplan trying to cement a victory for his team, threw the long ball into the end zone. A touchdown would have given ABC a 15-14 victory, but instead, they trail 14-10, down to their very last play. CBS has been defending very well. Once again, that defense led by Kevin. Kene Holliday back there as the quarterback. And they must have a touchdown to win. He overthrows Kaplan, who had beaten James Walker. But the throw too long, and so the victory in the football competition goes to CBS. Congratulations exchanged among the winners. The score, CBS 500, ABC 475, NBC out of the competition. Now, we want you to see the highlight replay. Cheryl Tiegs on the fly pattern behind Denise Nicholas, corralling the pigskin touchdown. And I wanted you to see Cheryl on that play because, as you've noted, throughout the competition, the women performers have been the key performers in event after event. Particularly the strategy employed by Gabriel Kaplan in the running relay, and then so many of the others up and down and in the obstacle course competition. There is that panoramic view of the Pepperdine University playing fields. And before we get to the final event, the tug of war, which will determine the winner of the competition, because of the contributions of our female performers, we want you to see them in focus. Folks, this is it, the final, the culminating event, the tug of war. At this point in time, the CBS team is 500 points, the ABC team 475 points. The winner of this event gets 100 points, the loser gets nothing. Thus, the winner of this event wins the competition in Net War 4, and it means some money too, because each winner gets $20,000, each loser gets $15,000. The rules of the tug of war, 900-pound weight limitation per team. The total team weight of ABC, 863 pounds. The total team weight of CBS, 854 pounds. Let me quickly warn you, that can be deceiving. We might get some words from Bruce Jenner about that. In the meantime, both teams are getting ready. It's time to call in my lovely co-host of this program, Suzanne Summers, and of course, the Olympic Olympic gold medal decathlon winner, Bruce Jenner. First of all, your prediction, Susie.
Okay, now this has nothing to do with the fact that I'm on ABC. I just happen to feel that there's a lot of power on that team. And having been on a team with Gabriel Kaplan, I know he has strategy behind.
If Gabe Kaplan has strategy, it'll be the first time. Whom do you predict?
I'm going to have to go with CBS because CBS, only in the first battle of the network stars, however you remember, ABC went off with CBS and they lost. Since then, they've never even had an opportunity to get to the tug of war. So this is their big chance and they're going to go after it. They're going to go all the way.
All right, let's find out how they feel about it. Susie, will you go over to the ABC team one by one, 5 men to each team, get their emotions before the finale? And Bruce, you do the same with CBS. Go ahead, Susie.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready as I'm going to get.
Okay, sound good. Parker, confident?
Yes.
Yes, more confidence.
Absolutely.
Okay. Okay, Steve, how do you feel?
I think we're very strong. Very strong.
That's a good attitude. Okay. How's your energy?
Fine, perfect.
Okay, I predicted ABC would win. How do you feel about that?
I think you're right, Suzanne. We're going to try our best. We're going to do it for you.
Okay. But now you heard it.
Yeah. It's been a long competition. We finally got down to the last event. You guys ready?
Sure.
Can you do it?
Yeah. We want to come back later and do some more.
All right. Good luck to you.
There you go.
Okay. James. James.
Yes.
You're in the middle. Have you ever done this before?
No, I haven't, Bruce, but I think we got a good shot now.
Good luck to you.
Thank
good
you.
Luck to you. Kevin, you're always excited about this stuff, but now the bones are getting a little bit tired, the muscles a little tired, but you got to come up with one more.
Got to knock my leg, but we're going to try it, and I hope we do it for the first time in 4 years.
Good luck.
All right, all the laughing is over. We're about ready to go. A number of the ABC team wearing gloves to protect the hands. Most of the CBS team, barring Tony Randall, have disdained the gloves. Bo Svensson, confident. Lynn Swan, number 88, Pittsburgh Steelers, setting one of two middle flags. The object in this tug of war is to draw the opponent's flag past the two middle flag dividers. Look at Bo Svensson. He's the key. So is Kene Holliday. Why? Because in a tug of war, the lead man is the key. And Lynn Swan is about to deliver the whistle that will set the two teams to going. There it is. Immediately from the rear, you see Bo Svensson, the lead man, digging in. Bo is wearing football cleats. So are others of the CBS team. They are prepared. The ABC team, not so. Kene Holliday, the number one ABC man, being exhorted by Toni Tennille. But Kene Holliday standing. And that's a mistake. You can't get leverage from that position. Gradually, the CBS team is pulling that ABC flag. The faces register the growing pain. The first time around in the first battle of the network stars, they went for over 8 minutes. They all almost died from exhaustion. Cheryl Tiegs taking part in something that she never thought from the beginning would excite her, but it has. Look at Kevin Dobson digging in, and James Walker, and Gabriel Kaplan is fatigued already. The captain getting to his feet, another mistake, and CBS is close to the victory. CBS has the victory in 55 seconds. CBS has won the competition. Let's quickly get to them. Bo Svensson, you did it. I must say you did it because the lead man is the key man in the tug of war.
Thank
congratulations
you.
To
thank you so much. Thank you.
This is the first time in 4 years. Captain Tony Randall. Great victory for CBS. Congratulations.
The reason is Bo Svensson.
That's correct.
Yeah.
It's all of us. No. It was teamwork and a lot of the... We just got it together.
Well,
thank you.
Jimmy,
this man's
finally...
fantastic. Bo Svensson did it, boss. Bo! He did everything, Bo Svensson.
All right. I have to admit, you're exactly right. Jimmy,
Howard.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Howard.
It's taken a long time for you, Kevin.
The fourth one, we finally won. We beat a good team. But this is the reason we won. Right here. Yeah, baby.
She's the one, and Bo Svensson along with her. Look, I want to... Here's Gabe Kaplan, the captain of the losing team.
That's the guy for the picture, you, Gabe. Svensson had any
Well, I think it's about time they won. and they deserve to win this time. They were the
really
best team.
They did. Okay. So, quickly, let's make the rounds of this winning CBS team. Toni, you've been great all the way. You're a great sport. Susie,
Bo Svensson's a guy who did it, boys. He really did. He trained.
That's right.
And he thought things through, and he gave us the strategy, and we really wanted to win. You know, this guy bought a kayak out of his own pocket. A $13.50 kayak that he didn't even ask us to chip in on, and we lost in the kayak.
Well, it was a lot of fun, wasn't it? It sure was a lot of fun, and you made it that way, Toni. Let's let the viewers recapture your personality.
That's only the beginning, and I will be no less truculent, friends. You can count on that.
You're beginning to have the look and the feel of a sawhead.
That's what I am. I'm an aging juvenile who has no athletic ability whatsoever, and so they made me captain.
Congratulations.
But he's very truculent.
There goes the judge, Toni Randall. And right now, I'd like to turn to these two great people and thank them for being so good all the way through the competition. Suzanne Summers in a new role. And baby, you're not just beautiful, you've got a head on those shoulders.
She did a great job, didn't she?
She really did.
I think you're terrific.
Well, thank you for inviting me,
and you are
wonderful.
Makes three. We all
don't believe all the things you hear about Howard. He's a wonderful guy.
Oh, come on. As far as Bruce Jenner is concerned, everybody in the world knows what a wonderful guy he is. So, for Bruce,
thank you, Howard.
For Suzanne, we thank you very much. We hope you've enjoyed Net War 4 as much as we have. The Battle of the Network Stars! And so, after 4 years of trying at Pepperdine University, CBS takes its leave with the ultimate diploma, a team victory. And during the course of the competition, you develop a feeling for the people who participate in it. Suzanne has, Bruce has, so have I. Let's give them one final curtain call. The executive producer of ABC Sports is Rune Arledge. The Battle of the Network Stars was produced by Doug Wilson. Directed by Larry Kerr. Technical director, Chet Mazura. Associate producer, Chris Carmody. Associate directors, Chris Carmody and Vince D'Addario. Now, here are some of the other people who made this show possible.